Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Roguelife. Today we are going to be finishing off our playthrough of Slayer Shock by Minor Key Games, or I guess technically by David Pittman at Minor Key Games. The whole corporate structure there is pretty difficult to really understand. I'm just going to be closing out Twitter now since I'm done tweeting about the show. My private conversation with the moderators, who don't exist, is also closed. Everything is fine. Here on Roguelife, we play through the roguelike games. I argue this one is a roguelike game. David argues that it isn't. I'm going to write a vlog, and by write, I mean perform a vlog about this kind of thing later today. It's really weird to see my screen on my face, so I'm going to turn that off. It's the very analog way of turning off things you don't like. All right, let's do this. Slayer Shock. Hello, Slayer Shock. How are you? If you answer, I will scream. Okay, hey guys. It turns green when I aim at good people. I've got a ton of money. I think my researcher is not here today. I've already bought all the things. Quick reload. Change ammo types faster. I like being quiet, though. Hey Jay, how's it going? I'm full on everything. It looks like my researcher is doing exams, so I have one choice. I'm gonna make loads of money, and I'm gonna kill a bunch of... Oh, I have to fight the vampire leader. This is really good. To recap what this game is about, is we are playing Slayer Shock, which is a game by David Pittman. It is... A procedural vampire hunting game. Fuck me. This is all terrifying. I heard the laughter. No. Of the awful. Fuck me. That giggle that I heard means there's a taboo in the area. Taboos are bad. Because they explode, they're sensitive to different weapons than normal vampires. Also, somewhere in here is my arch nemesis, Count Harrison. He's the big bad that I'm trying to stop. I hear you. Fuck me, guys. Hey, how's it going? Wow, 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 wow. Stop. Stop it. I said stop it. One of the weird principles of this game is that this is a shooter game, without guns, which is actually a pretty laudable, interesting thing to do. What's funny is that it's not that, David, who made this game, is anti-gun in any form or fashion. I think it just feels kind of like a crutch to him. Fuck me. By the way, there's gonna be a lot of cursing in the stream because this game, despite its primitive graphics, is fucking horrifying. That can't be good. I can't see a damn thing. Oh, wow, everything's making horrible noises. I hope that's picking up on the stream. Oh, hey, what's up, dude? Bye. Holy arrows, man. They're the best. You know, I would go pick up that guy's ashes, but everything's bad. I need the chest though, don't I? I heard that sound. That could be a taboo. Yep, sure is. Vial. Holy water vial. Use my bandage. Fucking pick the lock. Pick my crossbow. Hey. What are you? You're not an elite. So it's kind of neat. David's made a bunch of stealthy games, actually, at this point. He made Neon Struct, and he made Eldritch. Eldritch, which I just have a great love of, because despite Lovecraft being a terrible racist asshole, he definitely tapped into some sort of part of the subconscious that other writers just didn't... The weird wasn't a thing that existed enough. I know you're fucking in here, pal. Hey, how's it going? Boom! Oh, shit. Shit. Okay, whatever. Everything's fine. Oh, because I changed to just normal arrows. Holy arrows. Thanks. Fuck. That's Count Harrison. I saw him. Regular arrows, silver arrows. Files of holy water. Run, 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 run. Use the bandage. Crossbow. You fucking... Why does it keep changing ammo? Ugh. Man, you're actually really, really terrifying. Let's get back to the holy arrows. Let's pick this chest so I can get some bandages back. Because every chest contains every kind of thing, I am certain that this is something that will change in the future. So these are procedurally generated levels. The missions are sort of placed inside of them procedurally, which I find interesting. I'm curious structurally how this compares to Gunmetal Arcadia's system for doing so. Bye. Hey, everybody, investigate the thing. What was that weird noise? Okay, so I've defeated all the elite vampires. I'm gonna gather their stuff. And then I don't really care about the rest of this, so I'm gonna go. Mandy finished her exams. Yay, Mandy. You came and you saved me some candy. Make certain that you're still silver and holy. Okay, good. I'm doing everything right. So it's going to be three more adventures. I think that I can totally, like, bullshit that, which is kind of dumb, by just going in and quitting several missions. I mean, I guess I could buy this and just not equip it. I'll save my money, since I don't know why I would do that. Why is it only Old Town right now? This is Patrol, which means I'm just gonna cheat this. It's not cheating, it's just that Patrol is sort of a poorly, done... maybe this is what the game mode's meant to do, but I think I'm supposed to, like... I feel like I should be scouting something. Like, I should have a scout camera or... or something, because the point of this is to just go tag a column at the other end of this map, and then run back. And so it always feels kind of weird, because, I mean, I sprint the whole way, because I'm the Slayer, so I've got an infinite amount of strength and agility and stuff. And I can jump stupid high, because... And double jump, because I forgot that I could, because I've gotten some upgrades. But this just seems silly. Like, this is clearly not how this game mode is intended to be played, so I kind of expect... really? No one's chasing me? I mean, I guess I'll just take some free stuff while I'm at it. I felt kind of bad about how I did lockpicking until I saw David doing it in stream, and I was like, okay, he does it the same way I do. Hey guys, how's it fucking going? I'm just gonna jump over you. Womp womp! I find it interesting that my double jump is, of course, still a normal height jump, but my single jump is the super jump. How's it going? Boom. I'm also curious because I think that this level generation scheme is very similar to the one. Fuck. Well, whatever. I shouldn't be even wasting arrows. I should just be sprinting from one end to the other. Ow. Pretty quick, pal. I can also sprint in any direction, hilariously. Hey, how's it going? Oh, right. I hurt unaware people a lot more than I do aware people? That's not right. And tag, and... what the hell? So basically, I can't progress the game right now because Mandy keeps going to exams. And I can't get other missions for some reason. Oh, the threat at every other location has gotten too high. Oh, weird. Okay, so if I'm detected, they're gonna start killing the hostages. So I have to find the hostages without being spotted, but what's funny is... I've been playing this for a few hours, and I don't have the greatest grasp on how the spotting rules work. I genuinely feel like there's just an indicator, even just the classic exclamation point and view warning from Metal Gear Solid 5 that is just missing from this. Because the punishment in this particular stage is so chillingly tough and harsh that it just feels weird. So there's a hostage up ahead. There's usually elites nearby to them, so I need to be, careful to get them. Also, Harrison is going to be in this area. Somewhere. I hear you. Hell? And we all recognize this whole methodology is kind of dumb. Because they run terribly, and they'll go through enemies, and they can be attacked and all sorts of stuff, but whatever. It's actually relatively clearly told. What I want is actually certain rooms to be locked up with, this is a room where they are keeping hostages, and so it's got a door lock, and you're going to need to find a key and that kind of stuff, which is... basically, the only thing I'm proud of from my own level generation system is that it handles well the concept of populating a world with keys and locks without having any risk of you not being able to solve it. So it does make all the lock and key puzzles a little stupid because they're pretty easy to get around, but you can at least always find it, and it could be, practically anywhere in a level. So there are three inside of this big space. I don't know if this is supposed to be a garden or a cat. Oh, fuck, you're fucking below me. God. Everything's bad. Get out of here. Holy arrows, zero threat. It's wonderful. So, from what I understand, lighting actually doesn't matter to stealth in this game. That was something that I think I saw David tweet about the other day. It was such a big deal in Neon Struct. Damn it. Oh, okay. You're both. Weirdos. Okay, I guess I will go save this last person, who's almost certainly on the ground floor, because as far as I can tell, the the spawns for them all are on the ground floor in this kind of area. It's a little bad that I sort of know. Like, system mastery is always a big deal inside of any kind of procedurally generated game, and so knowing a little bit about its map building is always kind of good. But I don't know. Like, I might be getting a little too familiar with how. Fuck you, fuck you. Oh, wait, you're one of the hostages panicking or running around like a doofus. They need to be able to find their way out. I don't. I feel a lot like an easing of all the tension inside of these levels just because. If I can avoid detection and get this last person, I'm totally closing this mission and calling it a day. Like, oh, fuck you. Hope we can get audio of them just praying or something. Also, their hostage animation's kind of nuts. A new member has joined the team, Researcher. Mandy is back from exams. Mandy, who is also a researcher. Okay. How's it going? Progress, 2 days. If I have a new researcher. Want quick reload, even though I want quick reload. Okay. Oh, you don't go out the door, you do it here. Two more. I guess I'm in this just weird locked state where only Old Town and it's a patrol. So this is pretty weird. It's a pre-alpha build, so some of the campaign stuff isn't like, all the done per se. And I think I'm at one of those weird bad states, so I might need to click that box next to it, which is generate missions. Harrison will be in here somewhere, and so I guess I maybe should kill him. But it doesn't seem to do any good to do so. This is so obviously Angel's place from Buffy, and it's kind of nuts. I'm so good at this. Walk, 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 walk. Really? Nobody? I mean, I guess there's you. Right in the balls. Poor vampire. And I guess you're gonna turn into dust anyway. Nobody really cares what, fuck it. You know what? I don't need to worry about you. Just gonna run from the master. Ah, it's the master, he's after me. No! He'll probably taunt me for this afterwards. So that's the thing he can do. He can be like a total dick about it and be like, "Ah, Slayer, I will taste your blood," and like this weird hallucination or something. Which is technically actually how the nope and nope. Which is how the intro. Someone's broken into my home. Jerks. Mandy, 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 Mandy. I want her to be able to make like breakthroughs. Like I want that to be a thing. So that she goes, "Ah, I discovered this thing," or "I can do stuff inside of the missions to speed her up," because this is silly. Okay. Generate missions, go. Nope, still same state. This is gonna be a hunt. I guess I should still sneak. There's really not much advantage to sneaking in hunt levels. Other than that, I deal damage to unsuspecting foes. I hear sounds. heard you. Huh. I guess they're not. That wasn't an I'm charging you sound. I like the... I'm playing with controller, by the way, and I really love that there's just a touch of aim magnetism. Or maybe it could be called aim friction. It's a whole thing. It's a big part of the shock games, actually, and it's something that I really like about them. Fuck. Nope. I could use a bandage. I'm pretty happy with the med kit system inside of this. I've upgraded it so that I can carry twice as many, so I can hold 4 bandages. You can see them up in the top. I've got a button to quick use them. Got 4 more licks to kill, to use the fictional slang from the Reign of Ash book series by Rachel Judd. If anybody's following, you should read it, because it's pretty good. If you like vampire fiction, it's a place to find some good vampire fiction. Shit. Okay. Holy arrows and low threat are great. Fuck. Normal arrows? Silver arrows. Hey, bud. Yeah. You're a jerk. We all know. Oh, shit balls. I wonder how well garlic works on these guys. Not great. It's also not great. Wasted a bullet. By bullet, I mean holy bolt. This is a crossbow. These wouldn't be arrows, but whatever. Hey, bud. Boom. Ah, dumb. Okay. Hopefully there's a chest out here, because I'm having a serious ammo problem right now. And I will be in significant trouble if this gets really hairy. It got hairy. Whatever, I've got loads of money. Everything's fine. Hey, bud. How's it going? My mind space is kind of dumb, but that's alright. Locate Ness. Jay seems agitated. Hey, Jay. How's it going? Yeah, we know. We know you've got this whole thing. You're my weaponsmith. I need all the ammo you can get. Hey, Mandy. Vamp to do. Final mission type name. Okay. Let me see. Mission type finale. Dust 1000. It's gonna happen in Old Town because for some odd reason I can't go anywhere else. It's time. Old Town finale. Defeat the big bad. Possibly bads. I don't need to kill all of you. I just need to find the final dude. So, by the way, I would call this showdown. Side note. David, who I don't think actually watches my streams, showdown. Although actually having multiple mission types where it's like, oh, this is a This is a lich. You've got to kill his phylacteries. Fuck you. You know, they're things. Buffy the Vampire Slayer definitely had a lot of Creature of the Week episodes, particularly in its early seasons, and I'm certain that that can't be good. Chess? No. Nope. No. You made the mistake of spotting me. I'm sorry, now you die of holy arrows. I'm the Slayer. I didn't come here to play. I would be called the player then. Oh, I'm so bad. God, why do I even stream like this? These puns, they're terrible. They're not even, I mean, they're just genuinely, objectively awful. Darn it. It's the long way through this room. Safe way or slow way? Wait. Fast way or slow way? There's a box there, I could grab it, but whatever. Uh-oh. Someone spotted me, because I can hear quickened footsteps. Really weird that Harrison isn't showing up on my... Maybe he's got a special room? That'd be cool. Hey, bud. Fuck, fuck, fuck. Oh, this is all bad. Man, this is bad. It's a lot of elites. Shit. So the big bad's at the end of the hallway. Let's get some holy arrows. Let's get a lot of attention. Is that you making that sound, or is there somebody just, like, right on top of me? Oh, well. They count. Boom. Got my vampire dust. Kill the bad guy. I'm certain some delightful fanfare is playing. I return to the hub. Lancaster is safe for now, but the vampires will be back next season. Stats go here. Da 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 da. Ba 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 ba. This is bad. We're 30 minutes in, and I just completed the point. What does LP mean? Sure. Alright, guys. So anyway, that's how Slayer Shock works. I've defeated the big bad, and now, yeah, puns. I see that Brianna has joined the chat. Good job, Brianna. Welcome to the chat. Oh, good lord. Okay. So, I don't have. We'll check the map to see if it's different at all. I'm gonna give 10 LP. You earned 10 LP. I wonder what that lets me do. So I can once again sort of handle all of that stuff. He's got blueprints. Jay doesn't have anything new. I love that I've got Mr. Pointy. I mean, sure, like whatever. You womp. And you, sir. I've finished my training. So anybody in the chat got votes as to what the hell I do next? Because I've totally finished the game per se. I'm actually really curious to see what is gonna. Oh, can I? Come out of this next. There's clearly like a lot of space for interesting things to happen. Particularly like at this. I'm curious what I can do inside of the bronze slash coffee shop that this clearly is. If Friends were set inside of a vampire setting, this is what it would be. So I'm certain that we'll see more out of that. I'm gonna save the game because I'm curious. That's terrible. There you go. And then I'm gonna return to title. And hang out and chat for a bit. To see if anybody's got really smart ideas as to what to do. Who else is in chat right now? Just me and Brianna. Everything's good. Everything's fine. Where are all the people that were watching last time? Goodness. I guess in theory I could go play some Sunless Sea right now and call it a day, go back to my old addiction. Brianna has fallen asleep. Everything's sad. I'm gonna stop Slayer Shock because I've beaten it. I've mastered Slayer Shock. What are my options? Penny is not dead. Penny is still alive. I've got half an hour of stream left. Let's do this. No, the other people are asleep. Yeah, I know. It's so weird. The chat was so lively last time. I'm gonna close off itch.io, which is I'm growing to be pretty fond of, actually. Let's get this started. Come on, Steam, load up quick. We're gonna play us some Sunless Sea, where we might also run into vampires. This might just secretly be a vampire fan cast. Who knew? Yeah, we can't brand any swag, Pokemon Go, Brianna. I'm sorry. We can make it very obviously Pokemon Go. Like, that's okay, but we can't call it that, which means no one can search it. So it'll be super sad. Because I totally want to, like, I want a Pokedex. I want it so much. Library. Games. Enter the Gungeon. Duskers. Duskers, which just does not stream well for really obvious reasons. Fuck it, Sunless Sea. Let's get you going. Hey, Fail Better Games. Let's do this. Sunless. Oh, and I should change this to say. To say that I'm playing Sunless Sea. Yeah, I think that we should make sports red blue yellow sport team sport branded items and see if anybody figures it out because I'm certain they will. Go local sports team with your Pokédoxes. No, I don't need a controller for this one. This is weird. This is just such a strange episode. Probably in no way strange because I'm back playing Sunless Sea, which is, as we can tell, statistically the norm of this particular, cast. Is the music too loud, Brianna? If you can tell me in chat, that would be great to know. stopped at the tomb colonies. Jesus, I have no idea where I am. How am I doing? I've got plenty of food, plenty of that. How's my cargo doing? 37. Is there anything I'm supposed to be selling right now? How many foxfire candles do I have? If I went up, oh, I can't buy any. Damn. I can sell various things. Wait. I've got lots of memory of distant shores. I should go visit my kid and tell them things. I can buy fuel and supplies. Provide what I promised to the tomb colonies. Hey, first curator. I don't want to give him the mirror catch box full of very angry snakes. I mean, I guess. No. It's fine. We'll be fine. Let's look at our map. Actually, before looking at our map, what's just in my hold? What am I carrying right now that's so important? I've got a bunch of Syndallac, I've got a flare, I've got some parabola linen, I've got the stupid deck gun, because I'm a giant jackass. I don't remember what Penny was up to. I guess let's just go. Let's go Zailing. Let's check our map to see if there's any hidden islands, likely on the north side. I'm gonna go to Wither, I think. And then I can go to Frostfound and over to Mount Palmerston. This is my usual trip, but I think that's what I'm up to. I don't think I dropped by Wither enough. I think there's a bunch I can do there. So let's get going. Cancibus. Like a canticle, not like a, like I can't do this. It's the abyss of many can'ts. That would actually be really hard to spell if you had a pluralized of can't, of cannot. I need to keep an eye out because I've got enemies abroad everywhere. I don't want to fuck with a fucking lifeberg. Oh, fuck. Lights. Lights. That's not what I meant to do. All clear. Lights. Lights. Everything's fine. No problems at all. Everything's okay. Cants? Cants. Cants. Man, the spellings of these are just getting nuttier and nuttier in chat. I would put apostrophe TS, actually, for this particular spelling conundrum. The House of the Question. Northwest of Withertown, the House of the Question stands alone. Here, the initiates of the house make offerings to the three gods of the Deep Z, and perhaps a fourth who is not a god. It's the place in Wither where you can sometimes get a straight answer. For a price. Gaining the attention of a god is useful chiefly for lifting curses. I don't think I have a curse. Ask about the drowned man. The initiates of the house are reluctant to speak of him, but you may be able to bribe them enough to gain a few tenuous. This will increase your iron hearts by 5 each up to 110 and set your terror to 0, but you will never be able to remove any god's curse or benefit in certain other ways. I don't think I'm going to defy the gods. I'll ask about the drowned man, though. The drowned man's brothers, I, and sisters, gave him to the knives and the lacquer. Here we have no lacquer, only snow. Snow comes from the north. Lacquer comes from pain. We have it a little easier. Well, that's awful. You guys got anything for sale? Yeah, I can buy fuel with Z-Stories. Alright. I actually need Mutrasalt. Oh, well, too bad.
I can buy supplies with a Tale of Terror. Well, Wither, you were actually. I didn't actually visit Wither proper. I'm gonna explore the town. Oh, Jesus. An intriguing smell. Who will try? Who will buy? A street vendor turns skewers on a grill. The mixed scents are nothing like anything sold in London. Try the grilled troglodyte. Do you have anything more robust? Try something mysterious. A modest challenge for my high hearts. Let's do this. Rare and delicious. Tyrant moth antennae. You know how to deal with these. You break it into fragments and swallow the dripping fragments, each in a gulp, exhaling briskly to savor the vapors afterwards. It's a complex rather than a pleasant flavor, but its tonic effects are marvelous. Now I am genuinely hungry. Why did you do this to me? I've gained mirrors and fragments, and I succeeded at a hearts challenge. I'm good at iron. I've gained hearts. This is great. This is what I should do all the time. I'm going to gather some intelligence. Right, they ask me lots of dumb questions. No, we're not going to do shore leave and wither because my terror is fine, right? Let's get out of here. Fuck, Lifeberg. Lights. I don't think I have the stuff that the hunter needs at Codex or whatever the fucking monster here is at Codex. I need more iron because I'm trying to go pirate ship hunting to get money. That was part of this whole deal. Doomed Monster Hunter needs a Searing Enigma. Compile a port report. Because always do so. Wow! There's a harbor here. Nuts! Who would have known? A little surprised by that, but whatevs. I'm still not capable of handling Frostfound and doing its thing. Always a good time. I love the look, the little subtle animation of the buoys, as a weird side note. Like, it's weird how much personality that gives them, even though it's so subtle. Always do this because it'll get rid of hunger and gain fuel and lose terror. It's really wonderful. I'm gonna compile a port report. Continue. What do I need to have? Mirrors of 50 to enter Frostfound. Oh, right! That's right! The first, Eliza, my first captain. Eliza! Had a high mirror score. So what I would like to do, we're gonna be ending at our usual time today at 11 o'clock. Something I really do want to do is to do a marathon stream of this, probably at night sometime. And actually look into just fucking getting Penny killed. Like, just run this until she doesn't make it or she retires. And since I'm not in any way getting close to retiring, maybe do that. Either that or just lobby some people in the chat to be like, okay guys, I need to get this. I need to bring Sunless Sea to some sort of comfortable close. What's the best way to go about that? And they'll be like, death, and I'll be like, fuck. But, maybe there's an ending you can actually reach that isn't just definitively bad. that will still feel satisfying and feel like I got some closure on this phenomenal game. And it makes me think a lot about my game. I've been talking a lot. So my buddies started playing 7 Days to Die, which I might stream if I get around to it. I'm really fascinated by survival games, but I'm super picky about them. So here we are at Gator's Morn again. I always attempt to gather intelligence. My Veil's quality is terrible, so this is probably going to lose me a crew member. Oh! I have strategic information. I think I actually need that for something. Unusual activity. The whisper is that a Khanate Trimaran resupplied here last week under a flag of careful truce. That implies something interesting about the Khanate fleet movements. The Admiralty would love to know. I'm not going to sell that to the Admiralty until I can remember what the hell I was actually looking for strategic information for. I'm going to explore the Morn because I want a port report. A glittering eye. You turn, and there's a long, lank, brown man at your shoulder. Listen, he says. I have a story for you. Oh, sure. I'll listen to a story. A rambling tale. His story has a wedding full of murders, and a leafless forest, and a vast serpent which eats souls. The tale winds on and on, like the serpent, until you are lost in dizzy toils of its sinister ships and its glamorous corpses. You nod awake. He's gone. But not, it seems, before searching your pockets for small change. He took 2 echoes, like whatever the fuck. I gained some favor. That's all for now, and I've got a new Tale of Terror, which I should give to someone. I don't think I'm collecting those for any particular reason. I could go to Khan's Glory. Is there anything I can do at Khan's Glory? Not unless they're selling... Oh, actually. No, go back. Are you guys selling Foxfire Candles? Because now I've burned through enough stuff that I could actually go explore Nuncio proper. Fuel's actually pretty cheap. Oh, fuel's not cheap. I can sell it for cheap. Okay, fuck you guys. I hate you. Fucking pirates. I guess I'll stop by Khan's Glory. We'll see how it goes. That means I'm passing up on Mount Palmerston. Man, the musical cues in this game are good. I like this one, and I love Mount Palmerston. I ventured the tiniest fog bank. I don't really care about the Tamon. I'm gonna cruise past the clan palaces. Light blazes from every gate and window. You glimpse guards in gleaming uniforms, subterranean gardens of mauve and purple, hanging ornaments of scaled carnelian and jade, statues of warrior Khans past. The water is dark and calm. The sentries watch you with calm distrust. I've got some new suspicion, I got a memory of distant shores, and I've lost some terror. Hey, that's actually all good. Weird. I, of course, cannot shop here. Thank you. copper quarter, see what intrigue I can start there. Let's see if I can compile a port report, because why not? It's money. I should actually start fleeing. I'm actually running low enough on fuel that I need to either seriously consider buying a bunch more from someplace, or otherwise where I'm going to get it. Secret commercial license. Surfacer. Purchase supplies, pay a storyteller, gather port report. Establish a spy. Need a diplomatic agent. Seek intelligence, I'm not even allowed. Whatever. Gather a port report. Oh, I got it! Rivalry between Leopard and Eagle clans. The concerns about the Chelanet raid. Some appalling gossip about the traitor Empress back in London. Perhaps you shouldn't write that last one down and move on quickly. That fellow in the corner has an informer's look. Right. I think I'm still trying to get that special result out of the Chelanet. If that's the case, I can go by Khan's shadow and then go to the Chelanet. And maybe that'll be the end of Penny, because I'm overreaching my bounds as far as my fuel. Maybe this was all a bad idea, because I just needed to resupply at Mount Palmerston. Terror is still great. I feel like maybe my heart's not. I was wondering if heart. Oh right, I lowered my terror by 20 by having tea at Frostmourne. Oh, I'm gonna crash into the dock. Right. I'm gonna compile a port report. And I'm gonna go visit the shops. Traveler's friend, fuel ain't bad. Let's get three of those, just in case. That's where I can get mirror catch boxes. And this phenomenal... get Stygian Ivory, which I don't know what I need that for. Looks like we're all good. So now we've got enough fuel to at least go a little ways. And we'll drop by Polythream on the way out of the Chelanet. Hey guys, don't pirate me. I'm a good, nice, friendly man. I'm a friendly man in Friendly Town. Hey, Friendly Town, how are you? Don't kill me in Friendly Town. Actually, wait, what's straight east? Nuncio. I can't do the Nuncio quest right now because I did not bring enough supplies. Sadly, if there are foxfire candles in the Chelanet, it's probably worth going to Nuncio then. So anyway, I got a lot of frustrations with the survival genre. I hate, like, inventory management. I think it's just balls. It's a lot of why I'm not really playing Fallout 4 so much anymore. There's definitely a lot of... I really wish I could just tell my companion to go drop off all of this garbage that I have and be companionless for a short while. Like, it's such a mess. And 7 days definitely does the same problem that Minecraft has and the same problem that so many of these games have, which is just like, oh, I'm gonna spend half an hour or more managing my inventory. It's something I hated about Defiance, which is why we got, like, inventory management stuff into it. It's just like, I hate getting tons and tons of garbage. Oh, the fuck is, that is probably better than me. And it's coming my way. Okay, that's no good. What? Oh, that'll kill me. Eater of Names is like a super ship, if I remember right. I get something special for defeating it, but it's like a boss monster. Ow, damn, ow. How much did I take? 4? That's fine. I'm really, really very tough. Okay, speaking of other just really excellent audio cues. Boobity boom boom. Challenge. Obtain a doomed monster hunter. I do have a captivating treasure. I do. And I have a hunting trophy. Yeah, let's meet my contact. A mutilated hunter makes her home in a plastin at the wretched end of the shell. Well, the more wretched end. Her face is half immobile from jellyfish sting. Give her a hunting trophy and she'll share Z gossip. She has Z stories for you. Drowny whispers, Chelonite murder myths, truths found engraved on bound shark harnesses. And she adds, tell the Admiral. Our hunters are eyeing Estival. There is temptation now. She eyes you. But I suspect you'd know that, wouldn't you? I have an intriguing snippet. I've completed my commission. And I've got new strategic information, which I do something with. I'm going to get myself a doomed monster hunter. The Chelonite is stiff with monster hunters, awash with the pelagian juices that give them strength. A good number of them are doomed, too, but you'll need to provide for their families. That will suffice. When news of my death comes, they'll offer this treasure to the Bone Men. If they die, they will still be remembered. A cheery lot, the Chelonites. Let's do officers. You're not an officer. You're in my hold? Oh. Oh. Fuck. What am I supposed to do with the doomed monster hunter? I thought that was going to be a member of my fucking crew. Damn it. Who knew? Chelling it. Let's compile a port report. Tail for the bone. Someone is crying. Where's? Follow the sound. Ugh, don't have a hunting trophy. Don't have another hunting trophy. I can buy Stygian Ivory here. Can't buy much of anything else. Okay. Let's look at my map. I can go to Estival now. I think. Get supplies. Or I could just go west to Polythreme. I've made this trip before. Polythreme will tell. Fuel for an insane markup. An insane markup. Maybe we will go a little long so that we'll get me to London or dead trying. Almost dead on. Headed to Polythreme. Now, mind you, somewhere that pirate that attacked me earlier is sailing these waves, hunting me. I'm just never going to get a long enough segment without stuff to talk about what I think about survival games. And that's fine, I guess.
That's fine. Obey.
I love polythrene. They're so fucking terrifying. I'm gonna gather some intelligence. Yeah, because nobody cares. Carry men to London. I'm not gonna give anybody shore leave. This is the worst place to do it. Oh, it's right. You guys don't have fuel because you hate life.
Now I'm in a lot of trouble.
Does Mangrove College have fuel? Does Godfall? I'm gonna go down to the Mangrove College, and I'm 99% sure that Port Cecil does. Yeah, my terror is really high. Who cares? I've got hearts enough to handle. Oh, shit. Oh. Lights off. Everything's fine. Everything's fine. Get out of there. Your terror is getting higher than I like it to be. Lights on.
Whew. Okay. Everything's fine. Don't crash into the islands. Jackass, that'd be really bad.
You can turn off your combat mode. Something with a really big wake just flew by the top left of the screen. I don't want to know what that was. But I also kind of want to know what that was. That's bad, right? Hey, this is the Estable music. Shops. Fuck me. I'm in so much trouble. I will pick up a passenger. Where are you headed? Gator's Morn. I can do that. Don't have enough for the Wisp Blaze. I compile a port report. Oh, I gained supplies. I need supplies, because it's going to be the best that I can do. I've gained 3 supplies. You drink and be merry, I used up my time away. God, I'm in so much trouble, the fact that there are no shops here. Alright. Time to go to Port Cecil. Where I might play a high-stakes game of chess. Hopefully won't run out of fuel. Because everything's bad if I run out of fuel. What's sad is I was really hoping to hit folks up to essentially fundraising drive for Necropolis to play a stream of that, and then apparently it's not very good. Which makes me really sad, because I was really looking forward to it. I love me some Dark Souls games, I love me some roguelikes. I love me the English language, where I just grammatically screw up everything. But none of that's going to come into fruition, because the game's bad, apparently. This is the problem. So, like, roguelike has a lot of potential. That's why I've done this stream. There are some great ones like this. But there are a whole bunch of stinkers. And I think that's bad, and I actually do, like, essentially directly blame the roguelike purists for that, because there's a lot of innovation that's stifled by people going, that's not roguelike, and it's like, dude, it doesn't need to be fucking ASCII art, it doesn't even need to be, there's no persistence after death, like, it's like, dudes, that's just being super close-minded about all the bullshit. I could do chess, but first. Oh, nope. I don't have enough mirrors for that. Gather intelligence. Explore the coral, because I've got something awaits me.
Auroral rupture. A light grows in the far southwest. It begins like a distant bonfire, but very rapidly it becomes brighter, brighter. It looks remarkably like sunrise. Some of our crew fall to their knees, others duck behind cover and shield their eyes. One cries, "Dawn machine waking!" I can take cover, look around, but not directly at the light. What will I see doing it? All the colors rise in the rocks, the water, the crystal veins of the roof. The undersea is a rich, grassy emerald. The faces of your crew flash clear and strong, and you have seen nothing like it since you left the surface. In this place, it is utterly wrong. The light fades. Suddenly, men and women cry out, curse, one weeps. That's all for now. I've gained some terror, and I gained a memory of distant shores. That's great. Shops. I'm going to buy a shit ton of fuel. I'm going to buy all the fuel I can, actually. Because that's what it's going to take, and that's awful, because that was really expensive. You know what? I think I am going to play some chess. Boom. A distraction. Yeah, happened again. Alright, let's get out of here. So I'm nearly broke now. I certainly don't have the 200 credits that it will take me to go to the Salt Lines. So instead I'll take the southerly route out of here. Yeah. Take the southerly route back home. Go straight west, it'll be fine. I hope none of you viewers were hoping for a short stream today, like we could have had, and instead are eager to see this shenanigans play out. Really, really hungry though, so I maybe won't make it back to London. Brianna's laughing in the chat. That's never a good sign. Well, it means that one of my puns may have landed. Saints Haven. Oh, right. I can make decisions about the terrible dictatorship that I instilled on this little island. Let's see how it's going. I mean to drop by here every trip so that I can advance this. Hail Caviar! I can purchase Sinilac, I forgot. I'm gonna help resolve a dispute. A chill hangs over the chicken woods. The trees creak in the still air. The aide shivers. Do you feel it, hairless advisor? They say a monster lives out there. There are even... where even our light cannot reach. Our farmers refuse to tend their mushrooms until they can be sure of reaching them in safety. But we can find no trace of the beast. What can we do? Suggest raising the chicken woods. Declare their fears superstitious. Oh god, that's terrible. Our might is pretty bad. We've got a lot of civilization. Burn the trees, leave nowhere to hide. Fire, smoke, no sign of monster, alive or dead. Still, the adventure has given Cavia's soldiers fresh training of a sort, and the farmers will have little to fear walking this new charcoal path to the mushroom fields. I've gained a bunch of fragments. There's a bunch more might on the island now. I don't have the time to do another mission. I'm gonna visit the Red Gaga Ghetto. I can almost... I'm locked with two fuel. Smuggle fuel into the ghetto. Let's do it. This is so bad. I have a cache of curiosities.
I got a tale of terror.
It's a page from a journal. Until the sixth candle was extinguished, now we all watched the flame as it stood up, as it were on tiptoe, taller and bluer each heartbeat. Its light grew brighter in the moments before it failed, so that I saw the faces of all my companions, drawn and white as if we were already dead. When the candle flame drew itself up like a dancer and was extinguished, dark fell upon us all like a wave, and I heard the hatchlings uncoil. Now my spirit's really high. So what does that mean? I can't do that. I can attempt to broker a union. 60% chance. Whatever, this is why you do these. Houses divided. The rats are too angry to talk peace. The cavy is simply unwilling. If the two sides are ever to come together as one, it will not be today. I've lost some spirit, and I failed the spirit challenge. Do you guys have shops? No, of course not. Because everything's bad. Let's get out of here, then. I could just buy a bunch of Centillac from these guys, actually. Don't I have somebody who wants five? Let's go to Abbey Rock. I've gone through a tiny thing of fog. Everything's fine. Lick a monkey crag. Okay, guys, anybody inside of the viewership, I will not be playing this game on Tuesday. I will be playing a game on Tuesday. So get your votes in, or put it into the chat, or tweet at me, because whatever. What the hell you would like to see played on Tuesday. Tisdag, as they say in Swedish. I understand that speaking Swedish periodically will boost my viewership. That's no bleak reference. Nonetheless, it'll be fine. I'll talk to the sisterhood. Maybe they're hungry. Abbey Rock, how's it going? I still don't have a strange catch. Compile port report. I do have news. She doesn't care. I watched the convent. Everything's normal. Oh, I can do another hunting trophy. This is clearly where I go cashing in sea monsters when I fight them. Shepherd Isles, named because they were colonized by somebody named Shepherd, not because they actually have sheep. Man, I hope I remember my weird trivia. My weird trivia of fiction land. Next, we're going to talk about Star Wars. That's not true. Compile a port report of the boring island. I'm still fine. I've done everything that can be done at Shepherd Isles. It exists to make certain I have enough fuel to get to London. Nothing else. I guess we'll go to Mutton Island, which I also believe does not have sheep. Actually, these might have shepherds. This looks very much like a... Oh man, I'm so hungry. Why did I decide to go to London first? Ugh. The hell am I gonna cook? Who knows? Who knows? I can make one of my mega salads. That'll be great. This is Rogue Life, where we stream about what terrible food I'm going to cook. You don't really cook a salad so much as prepare. What terrible foods I'm going to prepare. I might just eat the computer, and then there will be no more streams. It'll all be very sad. Just nom, all this data. This data is delicious. Oh, I'm headed almost straight into port. Let's see if I have to adjust at all. Waiting by the E key. Oh no! It's fine. It's right on. Lined up perfectly. Perfectly.
It cost me one echo to chat with the fisherman. I'm gonna visit the hilltop above town. You stand on a cliff top, looking over the little village. Smoke from the chimney of the Cock and Magpie drifts straight upwards. As you watch, the smoke tilts. The sudden wind turns in a pencil smudge, then nothing. The wind screams unexpectedly like a god cut in half. What a noise! It must be the caves around the island channeling the air. At least, that's the most comforting explanation. Below you, the locals each take nips from a shared flask and make a toast towards the mainland. The wind is southerly. I don't want the rich smog. I love chatting with the fishermen. I have the port report now. Nothing dramatic. Shops. Everything's expensive. I have a little bit more iron than I did before. Oh, fuck. What are you? What the hell is that? Going to dissect you. I gained fragments and succeeded in a pages challenge. Got really nothing out of it. Exactitude. What the hell are you? I'm gonna butcher you for supplies. I lost a bunch of hunger. Let's get out of here. Let's go to London. Almost out of fuel. Doing pretty bad on terror. Nice, good, successful trip. Everything's fine. What are you? Tramp steamer. Man. There are a lot of boats all around port. It's really weird. Like, I'm not used to seeing anything, much less anything big. In the immediate area of London. Yet those guys had way more hit points than me. I don't have anything to hide from you guys, so do your worst. Like messages from the Harbor Master. Something has changed in the Neath, and someone wants to sign on. Always spend time with your family. So, time with the family. Just enjoy their company, because I already have a person. I'm gonna go to my lodgings, I'm gonna pick up the morning papers, because that's also wonderful. Consider retirement from Z-faring life. Retire to an elegant townhouse. I could get a Z-side mansion with 10,000 echoes. So I'm actually kind of getting close. I'm a little surprised. What weird curios can I build? Got one captivating treasure. I have a few secrets. Anatomical cabinet. Ooh. Adorn my lodging with captivating treasures. This is a way to pass money to your next character. You have no more than 12 heirlooms or 16 in a mansion, and you will need to pay a small fee to write these treasures into your will. Absolutely. Because I'm totally going to die. because I'm going to kill Penny. Alright. I don't have anything from the Labyrinth of Scholars. Or any reason to do that. Let's go to the Dark Spectacled. Actually, I need to... If I go to London, deliver the claim in, so that I've got more space. I don't want to hire on crew. I want to see the new recruit. Officer of the Presbyterate Adventurous. It's gunnery officer who increases iron and veils. Who's my current gunnery officer? She's probably just outright better. Let's look at my officers. Is she? Oddly, no. We will talk to her later. I think this will conclude it for the day. I'll probably do a little bit of cleaning up and selling stuff before the next stream. But I think that's going to do it for now. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for watching. Sorry that we got really quiet there at the end. There's a lot of stuff to do whenever you get into London. We will resume on Tuesday. Lord only knows what we'll be playing. Please do check out the doobly-doo. Subscribe, follow, do all of that stuff. Also, please do check out my book and my website. Our website at crookedthimble.com, or check out my book, Nobody's Business, by Trick Dempsey. It's available on Amazon. It's got a good review. And you should check it out and buy it, because I like money and the book is good. That's all I got. Okay, bye!